it's kind of weird to sit here and people are like, can you tell me about the fourth string defensive end who just enrolled in school and just graduated high school 2 weeks ago? What is he going to do for Miami in 2022? I'm like, work out. I mean, we got guys in front of him. We've been really recruiting at a high level, and we're trying our hardest to develop the older guys. And that's what I'm excited about is, yes, it's open, because for the longest, seniority was an issue under Diaz. I get that. What I'm saying is, even if the young guy is better than the older guy, the best guy will play. That's just what it's going to be. But if we get to the point, I've been a big advocate of this, instead of depending on the 17 and 18-year-olds, you want to get to a point in your program where the 21 and 22 and 23-year-olds or 20-year-olds are the ones who are really leading and are good enough. Not just out there because their classification says senior or redshirt senior or redshirt junior, but they are the absolute best, and they're the best player, and they're able to create a great example for the young men behind them. And when they leave, they continue to step up and do the same thing for the young men behind them. Okay, teach one, teach one, teach one. Okay, not just give, or not just, here you are, here's $1 million, figure it out. No, teach a man how to fish and he won't go hungry. Don't just hand them fish and then wonder why they get stubborn or stuck up. It's because you didn't teach them anything, you just handed it to them. Okay, so I'm hoping that the locker room is one of the other things I'm really big on. Are we developing the right mindset and culture in this locker room? And it's about the work. It's about the effort. It's about being grown young men. And what that means is being able to make the decisions that will never put you or your players, your teammates or your coaches in a bad position. And it's continuously doing that over and over and over and over. And first, it starts out with the coaches teaching that to the young men, and then really eating it up and digesting it and buying in, and then the young men being able to keep each other in line. Not necessarily police, no need to use that term, but just be able to look out for one another, love one another as teammates, and really embrace what that U brotherhood means and what the U family means. And if we can start to do that, the wins will come, Mark. If we can really start to build the foundation of this brotherhood and what the U means to the people who've worn it and bled for it, if we can get that interwoven into what's happening in 2022, I think we'll have a really good program.